ஸ்ரீ குருவியோ நமஹ சில்ட்ரன், வெல்கம் டு ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸ் ஏ கலைவா. டுடே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சீ த கிளாஸ் 1 ஈவியஸ். கிளாஸ் 1 சப்ஜெக்ட் ஈவியஸ், டாபிக்ஸ் அவர் ஒண்டர்ஃபுல் பாடி. ஷெல் வி ஸ்டார்ட் த லெசன் சில்ட்ரன்? See parts of our body. See, we know our body parts. Is it what is this? It is the head. Our head, we have some sense organs. What is that? Eyes, and then this is nose, then mouth. The mouth, inside the mouth we having the teeth and tongue. Then next one, this one is called the lungs. And then ears, we know that hair. These are shoulders, neck. This part is called the chest part, stomach, and this is the hand. Then it is the thigh. This is the knee. Then foot. So it is called the leg. We know this body parts, isn't it? This body parts, some spots having the some organs having the senses. These organs are called the sense organs. Listen. See, now we have to see about the sense organs. See, what is the sense organ? Sense means if we have any feeling, means that is called the sense. See, we are having the pencil, pens, chairs, and then benches, many things are here in our surrounding. No, if you are doing anything, means that things cannot get any feel. Any feel means it cannot cry, it cannot feel pain, it cannot smile. So these are all the feeling. These things are called the non-living things, because they are non-living things. So okay, they cannot feel anything. But a living thing can have the sense. They have sense. How they have the sense means, how do they show the sense means, if I pinch you means, suddenly you can get the, you're making the sound, no. Oh, why you are making the sound? Because you feel the pain. Your pain is going to your brain. So your brain giving the instruction to you to make a sound. You're feeling the pain, no. That is one of the feeling. Then if you are touching any hot things means, suddenly what will happen? You're removing your hand, no. That is one of the feeling. Why? If you touch anything means it will be hot. You can understand this is hot or whether it is cold. So you are suddenly removing your hand from there. It is one of the feeling. Then if you are writing or doing anything in your home, your mother is preparing some food in the kitchen. You can get the smell from there, no. You can understand she is preparing like this dishes, no. How we can say the thing? Because our nose having some feeling, that's why we can get the senses to our nose. These are all feeling. Okay, we can see many things. No, we can see all the things we can see here. For example, we can see the rainbows, colorful colors. We are wearing different color dresses. Then we can see the many sweets and like that. We are seeing many things. No, this is the help of our eyes. So each and every means these sense organs, some organs in our body, some organs having the sense. We have to see about that sense organs, and then we are going to see how they help to our as usual work, isn't it? See, actually how many sense organs do we know? We are having 5 sense organs. How many sense organs? 5 sense organs we have. What are the 5 sense organs? See, first one is eye. Without eye, we can see anything here? We cannot do, isn't it? We cannot see anything in the daytime, whether it is or night, we cannot identify. Suppose you are closing your eyes means, you cannot identify where you are standing or where you can sit, and then it is the daytime or it is the night time, we cannot identify this one. because the eyes only help us to see our surrounding. Is it? Next one is ears. Yes, we can hear different sound. We can hear the different sound, different music we are hearing. We are watching the television. We can hear different songs. We are liking songs. No, how we can hear the songs? Because help of the ear. Ear only help us to hear the different sound. Next one is the nose. Next one is nose. We have the nose, no? This nose having two holes. Through these holes, we get the smell. We get the smell from the through our nose. The see, in our surrounding, hair is present. This hair carry the smell. That's only then only we can observe the smell from through our nose. Sin. Next one, tongue. It is called the tongue. We have the mouth, you know, inside the mouth we having the teeth and then tongue. This tongue only help us to observe different the tastes of the food. How we can differ the tastes? See, this is our tongue, no? Our tongue having some small white like patches will be present here. Some white like bad patches. See, you're going to stand, you should stand front of the mirror. You pull out your tongue and then see front of the mirror. You can observe some small white patches from there. That white patches are called the taste buds. This taste buds help us to identify the different taste of our food. Isn't it? Then next one, the skin. Next one is the skin. Skin help us to identify our, see, we have the skin from the head to top to bottom, we have covered the skin. Skin is called the largest sense organ in our body because eyes is present in particular place, nose is present in particular place, even the ears also, tongue also present inside the mouth. But the skin is covered our whole body. That's why the skin is called the largest sense organ in our body. Wherever we touch anything, we can feel the same feeling. If I touch the hot thing, if a hot coffee or cool drink will be there, means if I touch the thing in my hand, means I can feel the cold. I can feel the cold, no, chillness I can absorb. Even if I touch my leg or I touch here or there in my neck, I keep some ice cubes in my shoulder or anywhere, means I can feel the same feeling. I can feel the same key feeling whether the thing is hot or cold. How we can feel the means? The skin is cover fully our body, so the skin is make the same feeling from the all the places. Okay, so that's why the skin is called the largest sense organ in our body. Clear? See, that's these five sense organs are called the five friends of our body. It is called the five friends of our body. See, why they are called the five friends means, listen, how these sense organs help us to know the world around us. These sense organs help us to know our surrounding. See, if your house means it has one window, isn't it? Each house is having one window, no? This window and the door only help us to know what is happening from our surrounding. Without window and door, we can see anything in the from the house. We cannot see anything, no. The same like without our sense organs, we cannot feel anything from our surrounding. That's why the sense organs are called friends of our body, because they help to know our surroundings, no. That's why it is called the friends of our body. Are you clear? See, first thing, help of the hand. See, we are having the hand, no? What is the help of our hand? Without our hand, we can do anything? No, we can do all the things, means our hand will be work. how the hand will help means, if you are, I'm holding the thing, no? How I can hold? I'm using the my hand, my fingers, my hand help us to hold the thing. Okay, if you are playing the ball means that there also your hand helps to hold the things. And then if I want to lift any materials means, if I lift anything means, we are lifting our bag, no? How you can bring the bag back to school? With the help of your hand. So hand help us to write, to eat, walking, and then hold the materials and playing, and is as well as clapping. We are clapping using with our hand only, no? So hand help us to do these things, isn't it? See, next one, the help of the legs. How the hand help us to do our work our own, the same like leg also help us to move our places. We have to move one place to another place means the help of our leg. If you just imagine, if you have any pain in your leg means, you can walk normally, you can run, you can jump. No, you can't do anything, because your leg only help to move your one place to another place. So leg help us walking, jumping, running, and then doing all the things. So without leg we cannot move anywhere, isn't it? See, now the uses of the sense organs. Listen, our eyes help us to see. Our eyes help us to see. We can see the many things in the world, no? We can find out whether it is the daytime or night time. How we can find out? If we can see the sun means it is the daytime. Suppose we cannot see the sun, if we can see only the moon means it is the night. Is it the same? So the eyes help us to see all the things in our surrounding. Next one, help of our nose. Nose help us. See, our nose help us to smell and breathe. Our nose help us to smell and breathe. I told you, no, if anywhere the delicious food is prepared means, without seeing we can say that they are preparing like this food. For example, vegetable biryani, we can say, no, it is the biryani, or it is the other chapati. We can say here, wherever you are, we can say, we can identify that the smell of the food is this one. How we can identify? Because in our surrounding, yeah, the hair is present. This hair carrying the smell and sound. Okay, the delicious aroma of the food, the hair carrying, the air particles carrying the smell. So these air particles enter through our nose. Our nose having some cells. These cells can find out the smells. See, perfume, flower smells, and then food smell. So a variety of smells we can find out. See, then next one is the our ears help us. Our ears help us to hear the different sound. We can hear the different sound. For example, we can hear the bell sound from the temple and church. We can hear the bell sound. And then birds making the chirping sound. We can identify the bird smell, bird or smell sound. Then next one, we are hearing the different musical instrument sounds. We are hearing the songs, hearing the TV sound. So we can hear the different sounds more. The same thing, hair are carrying the sound also. This sound enter through our ears. This ears having some small cells. These cells can observe the different sounds. This then it goes give the instruction to our brain. Our brain can identify whether the sound. the different type of sounds. Next one, our tongue helps us to identify the different tastes. Now we have to see the different type tongues, how the tongues help us. I told you, no? See, it is our mouth, we have the tongue here, no? If you pull out the tongue, you can see, observe some small like dots will be there. These dots only called the taste buds. These taste buds can identify the different type of tastes. You know how many tastes are there? 6 type of tastes are there. See, isn't it? See, first one is the sweet taste, and then bitter, sour. These like 6 tastes are there. We can identify all the tastes with the help of our tongue. Tongue having taste bud, the taste buds help us to identify the tastes. The last one is the help of our skin. Help of the skin. Skin helps us to feel. Skin helps us to feel. We are having the feeling senses. I already told, no? Whether if you touch, if you can close your eyes, then I touch with any pin or pins, pen or any other material. If I touch with you, means you can identify what the material I am using to touch you. Because of this skin having the senses. The skin is surrounded fully our body, so that it is called the largest sense organ of our body. What are the different type of the senses mean? Hot, cold, and then whether it is the rough thing or soft thing. We know that no, this toys like this things if you touch means we can feel the very soft. They are very soft thing. Suppose we are touching in the stone means we can feel whether it is very hard, because they are hard, no? So it is the rough thing. Then the ices, if you are touching the ice cube like that more, we can say that it is very cool and then hot. So see, our body parts, this lesson we saw that our body parts, all the body parts are useful in many ways. We saw that the uses of hand, uses of legs, and then sense organs. How many sense organs we have? 5 sense organs. What are they? Eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. Each things help us in different ways. All the things we saw in this lesson, no? Okay, children. This session is over. We will see the next session. Thank you.